In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an add to cart button with PayPal, which gives your customers the option to pay with major credit cards on almost any device. Using this button, you will be able to create a shopping cart for your website and accept payments securely through PayPal's payment processor. Also, I'll show you how to create a view cart button for your header. Now, before we get started, I just want to say that this button does not provide you with an entire e-commerce solution, but it does allow you to take payments on your website with no upfront setup costs. For large-scale stores, you'd be better off with an all-in-one solution that makes it easy to create product pages dynamically and plug in your payment and shipping modules all in one place. Speaking of shipping, if you need to ship your products to your customer and charge a shipping fee for that, unfortunately PayPal does not offer a practical solution for this when using their add to cart button, and I'll dive into the limitations of this in more detail in the video. That said, PayPal's buttons are a fantastic solution if you're just starting out and want to create an online shop, taking payments via your website, and want to get started easily and without any setup costs. Hi, my name is Tracy from paulandtracy.com. If you're new here, please feel free to subscribe. We share tips, tutorials, and simple guides on how to create your very own website. You can use both a personal or business PayPal account with this shopping cart button. To get started, log into your PayPal account. Now, depending on whether you have a personal or business PayPal account, the payment buttons are located in two different parts of your account. Once you get to the button creation page though, the rest of the steps in this tutorial are the same. Okay, so we'll start with the personal account, which is really easy to find. If you have a personal account, click on the settings icon in the top right hand corner. From the top menu bar, select Seller Tools. Under Selling Online, next to PayPal Buttons, click Manage. This brings you to the PayPal Buttons page. If you have a business account, navigate to the top menu bar and click on Pay and Get Paid. Under Accept Payments, click PayPal Buttons. Just so you know, you can also get here by typing in paypal.com/buttons in your browser. There are 6 PayPal buttons to choose from with different functions. Most of them only allow you to check out with one product at a time. This is inconvenient if you have an online store with many products where most people will expect to be able to check out multiple items at once. I'm going to show you how to create a PayPal add to cart button because it allows your customer to check out with multiple items in the cart all at the same time, all within one order. Creating the button is really simple. Click on the add to cart button. I like to open it in a new tab because PayPal's button page makes their navigation header disappear for some reason. And in order to be able to move around my PayPal account easily, I leave this tab open with the account header accessible and work on my button from this tab. The creation of this button is broken into 3 sections, starting with the type of button. By default, shopping cart has already been selected and we'll keep this option. In this example, I'm going to create a clothing store, and so my first product is going to be a hoodie. Comfy gym hoodie with front pocket. You can give the product an ID number. This is recommended if you plan on having a lot of different products in your store, just so you can keep track of what items are being ordered by your customers. For the price, you have 2 options. You can set a single price here and choose your currency. Or you can set multiple price options through a drop-down box here. Simply tick the box here and start adding a set of options. In this example, let's say we have 2 style options, one standard and one glitter. Let's make the glitter option more expensive. And we don't need the automatic third option. So to remove an option, simply select the field and click Remove Option. But if you need to add more than 3 options, simply click here and add as many as you need. And to confirm everything, click Done. Now your customer can choose whether they want a standard or glitter version of the hoodie. Now with clothing, you'll likely have size options and maybe even colors, so let's add those options as well. If you want to add another option, simply click Add Another Option 4, 5, etc. for as many options as you need. I'll add extra large. Then click Done. I'll add a color drop-down menu too. Orange, blue, pink. And then click Done. You can also add a text field to your button. A text field is good for letting your buyer enter personalized text for engraving or some kind of customization option that you offer for your product. But we're going to keep this product pretty simple, so no text field is required. If you want to remove an option, simply click Delete. You can use a smaller button or even link to your own design. I'll use my own design. Next is the shipping cost. Now, I mentioned at the beginning of the video that there are some issues with setting up your shipping costs using this button, and I'll explain that in more detail now. First of all, you have three shipping options with PayPal. The first is to leave this field blank and charge nothing. In other words, free shipping. That works. The second is to set a single price for shipping this product. The amount you enter here will be charged to your customer when they purchase this product, but it is only charged once. So even if your customer orders 10 of these hoodies, the most they will be charged for shipping is the amount you enter here. So let's say you charge $5 and they order 10 of these hoodies, then you will only get $5 for the shipping. Now that's probably not realistic and you'll lose money on the shipping cost doing it this way. And let's do another example. Let's say your customer orders one hoodie plus one of your other products, and you set the shipping cost for the hoodie at $5 and the other product at $5 as well. So PayPal will charge your customer a total of $10 for the two items. Now, if your customer then orders 10 of each item, it will still only charge $10 shipping for the 20 items. So this system is not practical because it doesn't charge an appropriate amount based on quantity. And there is another issue, and that is that you can't set different shipping rates for different locations in the world. Now, normally when shipping a physical product, you can set up shipping zones and set different prices based on the shipping address or zone of your customer. And of course, you charge more if they're overseas and less if they're not. PayPal has a shipping calculator, which is this option here, which supposedly handles this for you, but unfortunately it's broken. So the third option, which I really wanted to show you in this video, is the shipping calculator. But here's why it doesn't work. Normally this calculator lets you choose a country or zone, and then you can set different shipping rates for that zone based on the total amount of your customer's order, which is a great solution, only it doesn't work. The country selection is missing from the shipping module for some reason. Therefore, if you have a shop where you're shipping physical products to your customer and have to charge for shipping, I would advise you not to use this add to cart button. The reason that large e-commerce websites can offer PayPal as a payment option is because they've integrated PayPal into their e-commerce solution and handle the shipping separately. Also, in case you're thinking it might get fixed soon, I did a little research online and found a few reports from other users in the PayPal forum who were experiencing the same problems getting this to work that I had. Unfortunately, all of the questions have gone unanswered for several years now, so I can't say that it looks good for this to be fixed anytime soon. So I just wanted to let you know that whilst this button is a great, cheap solution for processing online payments, it won't suit you if you need to charge for shipping. You can of course try integrating the shipping costs into your overall product price, that could work, but it's not as simple or streamlined as it could be. If despite what I've told you, you still want to use the shipping calculator even with its issues, I'll include instructions on where to find it in the description box below. In this example, I'm going to use free shipping. You can either leave it blank or put zero. You can set your tax rate here. In Australia, this is 10%. Please note that the tax amount is broken down separately in the shopping cart like this. So when creating your product page on your website and displaying the cost amount, make sure to show the total including taxes so that your customer isn't surprised by the additional tax amount when they get to the shopping cart. Or you can simply put the taxable amount of $33 in the price field and leave the tax field empty, whatever suits you best. Just keep in mind that most countries that have goods and services tax or value added tax require you by law to show the tax amount. Here you can choose to display your merchant account ID, which is your business name, or you can choose instead to display your email address. For personal accounts, the only option that will work is to display your email address. We'll choose email address. If you're finding this video helpful, please hit the thumbs up button. It really helps us a lot. Thanks. The second section includes the option to save your button. This is always a good idea so you can go back and edit your button easily or even use it as a template to create similar buttons so you're not having to enter the same information over and over again. You can track inventory using PayPal. To do this, you need to confirm which item ID and how much quantity you have in stock. You can also have PayPal alert you when stock is getting low, and you can nominate a quantity here for that. So when it gets to say 10 units, PayPal will notify you that stock is getting low. You can also track profit and loss by entering the wholesale cost price here. This information is private and for your use only. You can also decide if an item will be marked as sold out when stock levels are empty, or if you want to continue selling despite stock levels. If a customer wishes to purchase an item but it's out of stock, you can also nominate a page on your website to send your customers to instead. In this example, I'll turn these options off just to simplify things. The third section is where you can customize advanced features. You have the option to include a special instructions field at checkout, such as delivery notes from the customer. I think this is always a good idea just in case there's something that your customer wants to communicate to you that's important to them about their order. And you can set the title of that box here. I'll leave it as is. If you need to ship the item to your customer, then click yes here so that PayPal will ask your customer for a shipping address. Otherwise, select no. What's really great about this button is how easy it is to redirect your customers to a specific page on your website if they cancel their order or once payment is successful. Simply enter the URL of the page on your website where you want them to be redirected to if they cancel their order or once their payment is successful. And lastly, you can enter some advanced variables for your button. But we won't be doing that here, as this is a basic video tutorial on how to create a payment button. So we won't be covering any advanced changes that you can make to the button here. Okay, now click Create Button. This will take you to the PayPal button's code. Copy the code from the website tab. Click Select Code, then right-click on the code and select Copy. We'll then paste that into our web page, which I'll show you how to do in a moment. So let's go to our website editor. In this example, I'm going to use the Wix website builder to show you how to do this, but most web builders have the same functions and allow you to embed custom code onto a page. Navigate to the page where you have your product that you want to sell. I created this product page earlier. To do this on Wix, from the editor, go to the left side menu bar and click on the plus symbol. And then select Embed, Custom Embeds, and then Embed a Widget. Click Enter Code, make sure code is selected, and paste your code into the box. Click Update, and then close the box. Now reposition the button on your page to where you want it. See this slider? If you see that, that's how it's going to appear on your website. So extend the box out until it disappears. Then you're good to go. I'll publish the page so it goes live. And here's my new button. I'll select a standard medium-sized blue hoodie. And as you can see, when I click on blue, the image doesn't change dynamically to the blue hoodie. If you want that kind of functionality, that's something that comes with a full e-commerce solution. When I click Add to Cart, the item is added to my PayPal shopping cart. If your customer then wants to keep shopping, they simply click Continue Shopping up here. Now to complete my product range, I would then create a new button for each product in my store. Assuming that you're selling similar products, to speed things up, you can use the previous button you created as a template for your next one. To do that, go back to the page where you copied the code from. Below the code box, there's an option to create a similar button. Click that. Here you can now override the existing information in order to create your new button. But you can leave any settings that remain the same. Embed the new button on your product page on your website, as we did before. and then repeat that for all buttons. For the sake of this tutorial, I've created 3 product buttons for my shop. Now I would also need a view cart button to put up in my header so that my customer can easily get back to the shopping cart whenever they need to from my website. To create a view cart button, simply click the create a view cart button here. But if you've navigated away from this page, you can get here by going to paypal.com/buttons, then click on view your saved buttons. Choose one of your add to cart buttons that you just created, and then from the action drop-down menu, select view code. From here, click on create a view cart button. You can use a smaller button or even link to your own design. I'll use my own design. By the way, if you're interested in creating your own design to use instead of the standard PayPal buttons, make sure to check out our other video where we show you how to design and upload custom PayPal buttons to your website. I've linked to that in the description box below. Okay, click Create button. Select code. Then right-click on the code and select Copy. Next, we'll paste the button's code into the header of our website. And now I'll publish the page for it to go live. As you can see, I've got a few items in the cart. When your customer is ready to check out, they would either click here to log into their PayPal account or use the guest checkout option here. If you're not seeing a guest checkout option, you may need to activate this in your PayPal account. From the top right-hand corner of your account, click on your account name, and then select Account Settings. On the left-hand side, under Products and Services, select Website Payments. Then next to Website Preferences, click Update. And scroll down to PayPal Account Optional and make sure this is turned on. Okay, let's quickly go through some of the pros and cons of using PayPal to set up the shopping cart that I've just laid out for you. There are many advantages to using PayPal buttons. They're easy to set up, there's no setup fees, PayPal takes care of all the back-end maintenance issues that you'd normally have to handle by connecting to your own bank, and they're a very well-known, reputable online payment processor. So the fact that most consumers know and trust PayPal means that they're more likely to do business with you if you also use them. But as with any product, there are also some disadvantages, and when it comes to PayPal's add to cart button, these include that it isn't an e-commerce solution as such, just a payment solution. That means if your prices change, you'll have to re-input them all again one at a time. Not so bad if you only have a few items for sale, but a huge headache if you have a store with dozens or hundreds of items. And you're limited on style options with only one button type, unless you choose to design your own button and host that on your site. I started this video with such high hopes because when you think about what PayPal does or should do, it's a fantastic idea. But I have to say that as far as this button is concerned, it has unfortunately failed in some key areas that anybody who needs a shopping cart most definitely need. Namely, the shipping module. I could only recommend what I've shown you in this video if you have a dozen or less products, because any more than that means if you need to change the price or other info for your products, it's more of a hassle than it's worth. And if you're selling physical products that require shipping, I wouldn't recommend this button at all because their shipping module is broken. Has been for years, and I can't see it being fixed anytime soon. If you found this PayPal tutorial helpful, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you have any website tips of your own or have any questions about the video or suggestions for what you'd like to see videos on, please feel free to add them in the comment section below. I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.